1, 2, 3, action! What is up guys? Fahan here with Za once again, and today we have Zeyang. How are you, Zeyang?
Hi, Zeyang lah. Zeyang or Zeyang?
Zeyang.
Zeyang lah.
I always have problems with Chinese name lah. My apologies. And this is Zeyang's bike, the Ducati Diavel.
Diavel.
Oh, Diavel.
So do you pronounce it Diavel or Diavel?
They call it Diavel.
Diavel.
Diavel. Diavel.
I saw on the most of the Western reviews, yeah. They call it is Diavel because Diavel. It's Italian pronunciation for devil, Diavel.
I didn't know that, but Singaporeans pronounce it as
Diavel. Yeah, Azizul mentioned in his vlog, right? He said Diavel. It's Diavel, Azizul. It's Diavel.
Okay, so before Zeyang actually tell us a story about his Ducati Diavel.
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 Okay, whatever you want to pronounce
it. We're going to give a bit of background about it.
The name Diavel in the Ducati Diavel 1260 means devil in the Italian Bolognese dialect. It is a cruiser-inspired machine meant to compete with the likes of Harley-Davidson and the Yamaha VMAX. It is a unique bike for Ducati, as it is usually known for manufacturing sports bikes. Engine is an 1198cc liquid-cooled Tesla Strada 11-degree L-twin, 4 desmodynamically actuated valves per cylinder, with fuel injection and a 6-speed manual transmission. In Singapore, as with any other Ducati, it is an extremely rare sight on the streets.
Alright guys, so shout out to our sponsor Lippi Moli.
Do check out their online store for awesome motorbike care related products.
Support us by clicking on the link below to view the range of products.
Or use our promo code upon checking out.
Okay, so Zeyang, from our understanding, this is your first ever Class 2 bike.
Yes.
And wow, I have to say, it's a huge upgrade from 2A, from whatever you're riding before.
Yes.
That's right. Last time, what were you riding?
I was riding the FZ60, then I got the R3. Then R3, then straight to this one.
Wow. From riding a tricycle to straightway riding a motorcycle.
Kids bike.
So why the Diavel? Or Diavel.
Diavel.
So why the Diavel?
Why this bike?
Actually, this was not my first choice, to be honest. My first choice was the XXR 900, the cafe racer. It's nice, it's cafe looking, then the engine is superb. But I had a friend who was working at Ducati. That was 2 years ago. Then Ducati had an open house. Then he asked me, go eat free food.
Free food?
My intention actually to see the bike. Because let's face it, Ducati is everybody's dream bike. I went to the open house and then I saw this bike.
Okay.
But before that, I sort of know if I ever want a Ducati, which Ducati do I want? Money wise, I thought the Super Sport was good enough for me. And Super Sport, I thought for a while, why not the 959? But on the day itself, I went down, I saw this. Not the exact bike, but I saw the Diavel. So I'm like, whoa. I put my leg over it. This is the one. This is the one. The Diavel is not a cruiser. Ducati themselves said it's not a cruiser. It's, I don't know how to categorize it, but I call it the fat muscle naked. The Diavel has the X Diavel, which is a cruiser. So it's a swept back and handlebar. Your leg is more forward. This one is more like mid controls. So your leg is 90 degrees. I can only call it a fat naked bike.
Muscle naked bike.
I understand. So it's not a scrambler also.
No.
then see the wheels already. It's not a scrambler.
Then some more, not only we have the X Diavel, they also have the Lamborghini Ducati. Maybe you can explain a bit about that one.
The Lamborghini is limited edition, 630 in the whole world. Recently, Ducati have one. They came in one. That's all I know.
In Singapore lah.
Basically, it's almost the same. It's just the fairing is all the Lamborghini fairing.
Stylish, okay.
But one thing I like about the Lamborghini, their exhaust, you can see the exhaust here is rounded. The Lamborghini one has hexagonal angular shape, which is very nice. The shroud also a bit different. For the Lamborghini, the shroud is different.
But really very nice, the Lamborghini.
Yeah.
Okay. So that time when you bought it, how much is it?
open house, they had the 9.3% discount.
Mm-hmm. Okay. 9.3.
Yeah, 9.3% discount.
Okay.
$93 down payment.
Oh, okay.
I never take the 93 because like you all said, you the less down payment you all put, the higher.
Of course, definitely
the interest. So I'm like, I tell them, hey, you help me lah. 1 month I can come out 700. So I just paid the about 6K down payment.
Uh-huh. Mm.
And
okay.
Subsequently every month 700.
Oh, okay.
For 7 years.
Seven years.
This is clearly this is a brand new bike,
Yeah.
How long have you owned this bike?
Going to 2 years.
2 years. Okay. So that's a lot of experience really. I mean, because previously when we interview most of the Ducati owners, they own it like 1 year or less. To have a 2 years experience on the bike should be well versed enough.
Talking about that, I took Umbridge. You all got the Hypermota.
Uh-huh.
You all interviewed the Multistrada. Uh-huh. You all interviewed the Monster.
Uh-huh.
So I took Umbridge. You all never come and find the. So now you all got the Diavel.
Diavel.
Super Sport, and. Scrambler.
Come out. Okay, this guy already come out with his bike. You guys, Ducati owners out there, okay, you come interview.
Two more full collection already.
And then the Superlegra. If there's anybody who own the Superlegra, wow, that is like
ultra rare model.
Very hard
to find.
Yeah lah, maybe we go to Malaysia.
Even the V4R also is like. What?
Actually, I'm surprised that you know there's only 2R versions.
Mm.
I thought there would be more, but I'm surprised there's only two.
Yes.
Two on the road, you know.
Two on the road.
Maybe the Superlegra, once we can go to Malaysia, we interview the Datuk there. I know Azizul said this Datuk he has a Superlegra. Okay, maybe we can hook up with him then interview him about his Superlegra. Oh, that would be cool, man.
I have to comment on this seat.
Yeah.
Power, sir. Very comfortable.
They have mine is the base model.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So base model, no Olin's, is Marzocchi front,
mm-hmm.
and I think Marzocchi back. Well, Marzocchi is an Italian suspension maker. It's also no slouch. It's also very nice.
Hmm.
Once you get it calibrated nicely, it's actually perfect. Perfect for me.
Oh, okay. I really like the rear suspension. Yeah, it's exposed and it's horizontal, you know?
Yeah.
It's not normal,
it's not like that. Because the bike is very long, so they have to change the suspension a bit, so to make it this way. Because if it's like that, then the bike have to be shorter.
The tires also fat.
It's one of the biggest tires out there. I think Diavel has the biggest tire in Singapore.
That's so
it's
cool,
a 240, 45, 17-inch rim.
Wow, if you want to change front and back, how much will it cost you?
If you go to Wern's, which is the agent,
that's correct.
600.
Oh, okay.
Inch plus labor, I think. Both.
Okay.
Tire plus labor.
I think it's not too bad. Typical of plus two.
Okay, kind of they told me, I checked online, they told me it's about 10K change one time. Mine is approaching 12K already.
Still okay.
Tire tread still okay.
Still okay.
Yeah, not too bad.
To me, it's like 10K.
I mean, you don't go for long distance, right? So, I mean, you ride around Singapore. I don't see the need to really go for stretch that. Really go for like 10K change.
I will change once the border open. I'm gonna change it and go. have to.
Okay, so much talking about what. How about its performance like? Cool. How would you describe its performance? The torque, the maneuverability, the agility in traffic.
Being a Ducati, I think it's a beast.
This is a beast.
You all had the VMAX.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, VMAX, I haven't tried before, but I know it's a beast.
Mm-hmm.
This one is beast-like.
Oh. Can call beast-like.
Beast-like.
Uh-huh.
You know, you all got the don't root beer light or coke light. All this. This is beast-like.
Beast-like.
But also not that light. If you, yours is a 1,262 cc bike.
Mm-hmm.
So it has way less cc than your VMAX.
Mm-hmm.
But it has 158 horsepower, 129 newton meters of torque.
Oh.
Which is like this bike off the line, right? Nobody can catch. TP also cannot catch.
Serious?
But don't.
You don't try, yeah?
Don't try.
PP cannot catch, but the camera can catch.
So I surrender.
How about the handling and all?
Okay. Especially in
heavy traffic.
Especially surprisingly, surprising. Okay, if it's slow, yeah lah, you have to both leg. But I can flat foot because it's quite a low bike.
Mm-hmm.
But if when it's going at speed, right, mm-hmm. it's actually very nimble.
Hmm.
Surprisingly nimble, but it's not like sports bike kind of nimble lah. But it's like you
don't have to put too much effort in cornering .
But also you have to control your traction control.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of levels. You know the 99 band, right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I took the default sport mode, default touring mode.
Mm-hmm.
Go for a 99 band. Oh, got at one point I cannot go down, because the traction control was set a bit too high.
Mm-hmm.
So I lower one level, I went again, mm-hmm. I can go down with it. So you have the bike has a lot of electronics. You cannot say ride on its default.
Mm-hmm.
You have to adjust it to your own riding style.
Oh, I see. I understand.
So like suspension also, mm-hmm. First time I also never go and adjust suspension.
Mm-hmm.
So when I brake, it's like,
oh, lemak.
So I made it, I adjusted the everything stiffer. Mm-hmm. So it's now very smooth.
So what other modes does it have? You know?
Okay, it has the urban mode, mm-hmm. which is your very sleepy, for raining time mm-hmm. or kind of weather.
Uh-huh.
That one is it cuts the power to 100 horsepower.
Okay.
So it's very manageable for city traffic.
Mm-hmm.
It also uses the less consumption.
Less fuel consumption, okay.
Yeah. So then there's also there's two modes, the touring and the sport mode. Both uses the same horsepower.
Mm-hmm.
But touring is more smooth. The throttle control is more go.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Sport is like go.
So we are standing near the bike now, and it's you can feel the heat. So for yourself, I'm sure when you're riding it, especially in start-stop traffic, you can really feel the heat.
That's one of the bad things. So at a traffic jam, right,
mm-hmm.
the fan only kicks in at 105 degrees.
Oh, okay.
My butt roasted already.
Your fancy jewels all become hard-boiled egg.
So it is true, a Ducati is a very hot bike.
Hot, literally hot.
It doesn't want to stay in traffic jam. It doesn't want to be standstill.
It needs to move.
But I think even in his hometown in Italy, you should have no issues with that.
Correct.
Because mm-hmm. climate is colder.
Correct. So when it moves, the air movement, the bike drops to like, at night it drops to like 76, which is like, it's okay.
Manageable. It's bearable enough lah, kan? Now, this one is my favorite question. How big is the tank? And what is the fuel consumption like? How far can you go on a full tank?
Okay, this is 17 liters. For all models, it's 17 liters. There's two consumption.
Mm-hmm.
One is the city traffic.
Okay.
City, I can get about 15 to maybe 16 per liter.
Okay.
Kilometers.
Mm-hmm.
If I go touring, which I tried once,
mm-hmm.
it's about 20 to 21 per liter.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. So it has two consumption.
Mm.
This bike needs to run. You cannot start stop traffic.
Yeah.
You start stop, you consume a lot.
So have you tried full tank until to the low bar? How far?
Yes. I full tank before all the way until the bike die. But luckily, there's a Shell station
in front,
100 meters in front. But they're 100 meters pushing 260 over kg. It's like,
that's right. Then should rename, cannot rename Ducati, 390 Katis.
I was waiting for that. It came ready.
I did my maths.
Okay, so Yang, let's talk about the modifications that we've made to the bike.
Mm-hmm.
This color is very unique.
Yeah.
What color is it? Like, I see certain angle turquoise, and certain angle is purple.
Yeah. Okay, talking about the colors.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, if you all seen the XXR 900,
mm-hmm.
there's a color that is midnight blue. I wanted Midnight Blue.
Oh,
Then I researched a bit. I found this, they call it the 3M flip colors. So I'm like, hey, this is nice, eh. I changed the angle a bit, I can see
different colors.
I'm like, hey, unique, eh. So I just bought it and did the colors myself.
Oh, okay. Originally, what color was it?
Sandstone gray.
Sandstone gray.
The 2019 models originally come in two colors. Black with a red trellis frame. And sandstone gray with black trellis frame. A lot of the guys I know all bought the black one. I bought the sandstone because the sandstone is quite unique. Because Ducati is either red or
red,
black.
Red, black.
Or white.
Very random white.
Have like super sport. And a few of the V2s, the new V2s, come with the white and then the red color eye thing. That one is also very nice. But so I chose sandstone gray.
So you wrap this on your own?
Yeah.
Oh, that explains all the bumps and bubbles.
I'm keeping the bumps to remind me of my mistakes. I probably rewrap it maybe next time, but remind me of my own mistake.
Besides this, I see that you put a windshield. Yeah. Did you do this on your own or?
I did this on my own.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I cut it out myself. I designed it myself. You see the horns, right?
Like devil like that. Is it the name?
But actually, I didn't think so much. Okay, originally, there were two screws. This thing was holding on to the windshield. So the screws like pop out. Then it's like, you can see it's the screw. So I'm like, I see people wearing helmets with this horn thing. So I'm like, hey, where did they get the horn? I asked the guy, oh, you buy it online. So I go and get. I just put the silicone glue, stick the two.
It's so cool, man. This is so cool. That's why when I see this bike got windshield, man, because originally it's naked.
The bike itself has for OEM windshield, which is very short. But I've never tried before, but I don't think it can block the wind. This one, I went 130 before, not in Singapore, in Malaysia. 130, it can
withstand the wind resistance. That's cool, man. So you did this on your own?
Yes.
You make? Happening.
You went to shop, is it?
This is
the equipment.
I have all the equipment.
Oh, you have all the equipment?
That's cool, bro.
Or I have access to some of the equipment.
No wonder.
I can do all these things.
What other accessories you reckon there's available for the
Diavel?
Actually, the bike itself, you don't really need much accessory. Because exhaust, one thing, the exhaust, there's only one, Termi, from Wurns themselves. But it's racing only. It's louder, but it's not legal. And it's like $6,000 add-on.
Wow! You can make down payment for another bike.
Yes. For this default exhaust itself, when it first came, it wasn't that loud. I also don't know why it's loud, because this is my first
custom bike.
So to me, it's loud enough. And then over the years, I went back to YouTube. I checked the original sound. How come the original sound so much more high pitch? This one is like after 2 years, the sound became slightly lower pitch. I can hear, my bike is a bit lower.
Is it because of the wear and tear?
It might not be wear, it might be like running ready.
Understand.
And then there might be like a lot of thing inside the thing, so it's like heavier, so the sound is like more low. I don't know but I check back to the old YouTube videos, the original when they first start, the pitch is higher. My one is not so high anymore.
So it becomes like a growling.
It's more growly.
Is it the name devil?
For the 2 years that you own this bike, right? Has this bike given you any problem or not? Has the engine? How's the engine like? How is your maintenance schedule?
Actually, I would say one major problem. One of the header. Leak oil. But it was under warranty, so Ducati honored their warranty.
That's why,
Ducati. They're always serious about Ducati. They are good after sales support.
Yes, that's why.
Ducati, I love you.
So if you want to buy a Ducati, make sure buy straight from the dealer.
Make sure got warranty.
Don't buy second hand.
Can extend, better extend.
Like Aziz don't say, warranty is gold.
Okay, so anyway.
So they changed the header. Took about 1-2 months. But then everything okay. Then another incident was when I lost my key. 2019, I went touring. I wanted to go Hat Yai with a few other friends. But I lost my key.
Okay.
I lost somewhere at Pago, so I couldn't go. And then I couldn't open my tank.
Why the key is behind?
Okay. The key is not here. Oh.
This bike, one thing about keyless bike, either you hang it on you or you keep it inside your bag or something, or you bring a spare key.
Because this is just a transponder actually.
This is keyless.
Oh, this is
so keyless. You will forget your key.
Oh, so the physical key is only for opening the fuel tank.
And then the
seat.
The storage under here, right?
Okay.
Storage very small.
Very small, later we'll see.
I lost my key. It's about a $600 replacement. Okay. That one no warranty, because it's my own fault. I can't say anything. But I had to abandon my trip. I was at KL for a few days.
So
took some picture, Twin Tower.
The typical touristy shit.
I wouldn't call it touristy shit, because I tried to go in, there was no way to go into the Twin Tower to take photo.
So do you approach Ducati dealership in KL to rectify your
replace? They can't do it. KL can't do it. I have to go back Singapore to do it.
Oh, okay.
Because where you buy from, you have to.
Did you sell like that?
It was very late at night. So I found the nearest hotel I can. Park the bike there. Make sure it's at least a 4-star.
You have parking. You have available jaga. Parking.
People jaga, pay the guy. So next morning, I took a bus all the way back to Singapore. Take my spare key, then go back to KL.
bring back the bike.
not immediately, because I was there already. Might as well just spend the next few days there. I already took leave. Might as well.
Oh, yeah, might as well.
Then the suck thing was, because I went on the National Day holiday weekend. Coming back,
jam.
Still got bus. Going back, I almost couldn't find a bus back.
Oh, that sucks, man.
You imagine the bike stuck there. I was so
anxious. Oh my god, that must be hard on you, sir.
Then have to cancel away the DUC, you change to M. Mati.
That was good, actually.
Oh my god.
Maintenance, until now, I did the 1,000. I did the first year. I'm coming down. 2 more months, I'm doing the second year. So this bike, it's not like the old Ducatis. The servicing interval for this bike is like 15,000 K.
15,000. Okay.
Recommended is 7.5 K you do one time.
Okay.
Because 1 year this bike a bit hard to hit 15 K.
Considering if you are going to be in around Singapore.
Yeah. Even if you tour once a month, to JB or something, it's also a bit hard to hit 15. For me, I do it once a year. It's about 600 one time.
So that includes the oil change, how many?
The last price I got 600 was include the brake bleeding, clutch bleeding, brake pad change, oil change, filter change, I think spark plug also got change. This one 4 spark plug.
4 spark plug.
Because this is twin spark.
Okay.
So it's a more full explosion.
So how many liters of oil? Engine oil?
Reckon?
One bottle.
I forgot. I think it's four liters.
Should be.
So where you usually do it at Werner's, is it?
Werner's. Because it's still under warranty. Warranty, go back to Werner's.
You'll never trust any other shop to do it.
Until warranty over.
You can experiment.
Oh yeah, and one more very nice thing about this is that there's more servicing, right? Mm. It's about 30K.
30K?
30K okay. For the Desmo. So, it's like what? I'm now only like 12,000. And it's 2 years already. So I think by the time 6 years, then maybe...
Then can reach the 30K. Yeah. Yeah.
So Sayang, this is your daily rider, right?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Is it
It used to be my R3.
Oh, I see.
I sold my FZ a few months ago. So now this become my...
Every day you go to right?
Is it difficult or not as a daily?
The morning traffic is cooler, so it's not so bad. Mm-hmm. But when you finish work, you want to go home...
So how far you commute? Where do you stay?
Luckily, my workplace is very near my home.
Okay, not too bad lah. Okay, so how far have you gone with on this bike?
I wanted Hat Yai, but only got KL.
Oh, that is the only once and the only time you went for touring lah.
First Gen 3 in KL. First Gen 3 in KL.
So do you get a lot of looks when you're riding the Davel around?
Yes, definitely. Mm. Whichever model you are in, as long as you're a Ducati, people will sure they want. Because the word down there, people see it.
Ducatis, yeah.
Ducatis, yeah.
That's their reputation. I have to admit that.
So, youngsters, Ape, everybody will see.
I think I will get myself a Ducati also.
another dream bike, right?
Not really. I'm not a fan of Ducati actually.
Oh. I'm a fan of Italian. So Ducati might be in my stable if I have the spare cash.
Not Gilera.
Gilera as well. Anything Italian. All the Italian range of bikes.
The thing about Ducati is that the old models, the pre-2000s, a lot of problems. But recently, because Ducati themselves, they are bought over by this Volkswagen. Volkswagen changed a bit of their internal management, a lot of their internal processes. Mm-hmm. So now I can safely say that their bike is.
It's not more reliable.
Not as on par as the Big Four. But it's up there.
Yeah. I guess they brought in German technology in it.
Correct.
Yeah, I think so. because we always have been hearing complaints about Ducati being a motosake, unreliable, and when it breaks down, the repairs is too expensive.
But it's mostly for the older generation. Yeah. The newer ones, actually not bad. Seriously not bad.
Okay. Well, that is very reassuring.
So Sayang, what's your best memory so far with this bike?
I'm losing the key.
Oh, bittersweet memory.
Bittersweet memory.
But surprisingly, you didn't need the bike to get a new key.
Because the spare key I got was the master key. Once we'll give you both keys. The red key, which is your master, and this key, your transponder key. Anyway, I'll be a very thick yenya, so I will never lose it. So don't lose your master, you lose because the master inside has the chip. So they need that chip to go and
duplicate
your coding.
So if you want to duplicate the master, you have to bring the bike lah.
Correct.
I see.
I understand already.
Okay. That explains the why it's so expensive.
Who would you recommend the Divel?
Diavel.
Diavel for?
I don't want to say deep pockets because there are other range which is within reach. By their scramblers, their lower CC, their scramblers,
their
lower CC motards, their lower CC monsters, they are actually within reach. I don't want to say people with deep pockets, but people who want to chase their dream. Because let's face it, all bikers, Ducati is a dream. BMW, any Conti is a dream. So for me, I thought when I was at the open house that day, I thought like, might as well chase it now. Because once I get married, you tell me to get Ducati, my wife will kill me.
Then you change to Mati. The Duke, throw away your M. Mati.
Okay, so personally, like I said, not really a fan of the Diavel.
It's okay.
Not really a fan of the naked class of motorcycles. But it's nice to have.
This is a beautiful bike by itself. I mean, I wouldn't... It's not to my liking though, right? Because I love the touring categories of bike. But I'm impressed with the technology, with the design and engineering that Ducati has brought forward on this bike. It's very impressive.
I mean, the Italians really know how to do a bike. Let's face it.
Hey, wait, just now German already bought one.
Oh yeah.
So German.
The factory is still in Italy. But it's under German
control. Management.
Hey, thank you, Chayang, for coming out and coming out to review the bike. If I ask the Ducati
Diavel.
And that's it for the vlog. Any riders want to review the bike, ask. You get in touch with us on our social media pages below.
Okay. Diavel riders out there, or all any Ducati riders out there, if you have anything else to comment or add in, please put it in the comment section below. And if you are riding a Ducati which we have not yet featured in our vlogs, please PM us and then we want to get in touch with you. And like and share this video if you're riding kakis, and don't forget to subscribe and do support us and our awesome sponsor Liquimoli by visiting their website and making their any purchases you want to make. You use our promo code TAMBAK10 for additional discount, or you can check out their bi-weekly promotional special. Yes, and get more than 10%. Yeah. I think 30-40%.
Yeah. Maybe. And that's it for the vlog, and we will see you in the next one.